Multicast DNS or mDNS evolved out of regular DNS for use in local networks and allows devices on your network to perform DNS queries to each other without relying on a single DNS server. In addition to this, mDNS implies that any given device can come up with the .local domain name for themselves, and they can use these names to advertise the services that they offer. A typical scenario is that you add a new device to the network, and if it relies on mDNS, it will immediately use IPv4 and IPv6 multicast addresses to talk to any devices that care to listen. It pretty much just announces that it is there, and it checks if its chosen domain name is not already taken. But the main feature is that it starts to listen and reply to mDNS queries through those multicast addresses. The obvious benefit here is that you do not need to know the IP address of the device, because at any given time you could just query its domain name and it will respond with its current IP. And even better, because of a feature called DNS Service Discovery, or DNSSD, you can use mDNS to ask the whole network if there are any providers of a specific service. For example, are there any printers here? Are there any network storage locations? Or are there any video streaming devices? And so on. All the respective devices will respond with their domain names, IP addresses, and even any additional details that might be necessary to start working with the given device or service. What makes this protocol even more convenient is that you don't need to do any configuration on your network equipment if you want to use it in a single broadcast domain, or in other words, in a single LAN address space. But in practice, a lot of smart IoT products that rely on mDNS are not very trustworthy, so you really want to separate them in another network or VLAN so that you can prevent them from trying to brute force the password of your NAS or just limit their ability to participate in botnets if they get compromised. We'll have a look at the security measures you can take with IoT devices in another video, but the result of such measures is often broken mDNS functionality. However, RouterOS has a built-in solution. An mDNS repeater is a very simple networking equipment feature. It takes the mDNS multicast messages originating in one network or broadcast domain and simply retransmits them in another. This means you can have your smart IoT devices in a separate VLAN from the servers and computers that you use to control them. To enable this feature, go to the DNS settings and look for mDNS repeater interfaces. There you can add individual physical ports, bridge interfaces, or in VLAN filtering setups, you'll want to add the routed VLAN interfaces. Save the settings and you're done. Now, nothing convenient comes without its downsides. In this case, you probably don't want to use mDNS in enterprise environments or out of principle. If a lot of devices are participating in this multicast back and forth, then it creates unwanted noise in the traffic that could even result in congestion at some point. But it could get even worse than that. If any device in your network can freely come up with its domain name, then what's stopping a light bulb from pretending that it is the printer you use for important documents, for example? Various mDNS-based attacks are possible, so you might want to prevent its use altogether. You could do it with firewall rules that target the port 5353 and associated IP version 4 and IP version 6 addresses. But in the end, it is up to you to decide how you want to treat it. Let me know in the comments. Are you using mDNS freely, or are you trying to block it actively? See you next time.